is the sole survivor of a horrific home invasion that left his wife and daughters dead and his home burned down. Dr. Petit met his wife, Jennifer, here in Pittsburgh. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggins spoke to Jennifer Pettit's parents, Sal.
That's right, Wendy. Reverend Richard and Mary Bell Hawk were at their Venice, Florida home this afternoon. They still also live in Slippery Rock and have been with their son-in-law since the trial for the two suspects, or at least the first suspect, began. One, Stephen Hayes, has been now convicted and sentenced to death. The Hawks told me that they were not afraid to watch the Oprah program and, in fact, hoped it would silence some of the repeated questions and spread the word about how wonderful and giving Jennifer and their granddaughters, Haley and Michaela, were.
We're not angry, and we have worked through our grief quite well, it seems, because we've had such a big supportive community of friends.
And their son-in-law has lived with his parents since his home burned to the ground in 2007 with his tortured and murdered family inside.
Without my family, I would have been totally lost. Mm-hmm. You know, so I don't know how you get through something like this without family and a huge village of support.
Mm-hmm. There's still quite a bit of anger that comes from his realization of losing everything.
A hole in his heart. It'll never be mended, and that's probably true for all of us that have been involved.
The daytime is easier to focus on positive things.
On the life, on
yes,
their life.
Yes. Falling asleep and waking up are the hardest times. The transitions from sleep to wakefulness pretty much comes back every day.
And how does a retired Methodist minister feel about the death sentence for Stephen Hayes?
Coming to understand more about the terrible things that can be done to people, it seems to me that the death penalty can be a deterrent.
Mrs. Hawk agreed with her husband, even though the United Methodist Church, where Reverend Hawk was once a district official, opposes the death penalty. Many of the Hawk supporters are still here in our area, where Reverend Hawk was once a pastor in Dormont and where Jennifer attended Keystone Oaks High. In February, the other suspect, who was accused of sexually assaulting Pettit's 11-year-old daughter, goes to trial. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.